The committee right now releasing hundreds of newly declassified documents, all related to the origins of the Russia probe. Jillian Turner combing through those quickly. Have you found much yet? Jillian, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. So far, Bill, the Senate Judiciary Committee just released these documents online. This after they were declassified by the president, then cleared for review by the Attorney General. As you mentioned, Bill, there are hundreds of pages. We're still combing through them right now. But what I can tell you is that we are getting a whole lot of holes filled in about the origins of the 2016 investigation into the Trump campaign's alleged ties to the Russian government. A lot of new detail here, so stick with me, Bill. In releasing these documents, first off, Senator Graham says, "I consider the Crossfire Hurricane investigation a massive system failure by senior leadership, but not representative of the dedicated, hardworking patriots who protect our nation every day at the FBI and DOJ." Now, Graham then gets specific. He says, "The FISA court was lied to. Exculpatory information was withheld on those being investigated. And the leadership of the FBI under Comey and McCabe was either grossly incompetent or they knowingly allowed tremendous misdeeds. There was a blind eye turned toward any explanation other than the Trump campaign was colluding with foreign powers." Now, in these documents, what we have, Bill, are 11 interview transcripts with former and current government officials who themselves worked directly on the very start of that investigation as it was launched and then first getting underway. Some of those officials reference the now infamous FBI debriefings of Christopher Steele and his subsource, who we did learn in the fall was also under investigation by the FBI at that time. Some of the interviews also talk about Cambridge professor Stefan Halper. He's important because he was in contact with Trump campaign aides Carter Page and George Papadopoulos, all of which has been known for several months, but we're getting new detail now. So in big picture story here, Bill, we're getting lots of color, some nitty-gritty detail about the origins of the Russia probe, all of which, in summation, continues to undercut the legitimacy of the Steele dossier, as we now know, the key intelligence document, or one of the key intelligence documents that supported the launch of this probe in the first place. Bill?
Jillian, thanks. Jillian Turner, get back to work. We'll bring you back if you get more. Thank you.